An Epik hack of Epik customer data, Apple patches exploits used by Pegasus spyware, and ExpressVPN comes under fire. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for September 21st, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. By the way, a huge thank you to Tasty Cake for joining this week. I love your screen name. All of our Patreon Alliance members get access to a Discord server, and it's so active. We actually have over 700 members, and I'm constantly chatting with everybody in there. Patreon.com/ThreatWire, as always, for that, and we have some excellent stories to get into today, so on to the news. Anonymous is back in the news this week with a big data leak stemming from Epik, which is an online service provider offering domain names, hosting, and DNS services known for right-wing clients. Now, Epik often supports businesses which have been denied by other providers because of the content hosted on these platforms. Some of Epik's clients include 8chan, Gab, Parler, the Texas GOP, and more. Anonymous obtained and leaked 180 gigs of data from Epik as a torrent and stated it included decades worth of data from the company. This was Anonymous's response to Texas's new restrictive and anti-choice abortion ban in a hacktivist operation that they dubbed Operation Jane, also known as Operation Epik Fail. Now, the original journalist who spotted the leak posted his scoop on Twitter, and he was later doxxed by an Epik supporter. Epik stated that they weren't aware of any security breach, so Anonymous also altered their knowledge base in response, and Epik then removed that page, and several days later, they did confirm an unauthorized intrusion did occur. The data is organized as SQL databases, and it includes customer records associated with domain names. In total, over 15 million email addresses were included. Epik themselves reportedly scraped Whois records from domains and stored them, so not all of the email addresses were actually customers of Epik's. Now, Troy Hunt of HaveIBeenPwned.com received positive responses from followers who requested notifications of pwned email addresses, since much of them were scraped from those Whois records, including his own. Along with email addresses, names, phone numbers, physical addresses, purchases, and passwords were stored in the leak. If you own a domain, you would have had to enter Whois data as a part of that setup process. So signing up for a notification from HaveIBeenPwned.com may be a good consideration to make, even if you aren't a customer of Epik's. Given that Epik was reportedly harvesting and storing that kind of information on people who may not necessarily be clients of Epik, some wonder if there is any kind of legal recourse that could be taken. Apple just released some security updates to patch CVE-2021-30860, a major vulnerability that required no user interaction, but it could own the latest Apple devices with Pegasus spyware, the malware used by the Israeli NSO group to target individuals. Now, since it requires no interaction, the vulnerability was dubbed forced entry by the researchers at Citizen Lab, who first found the flaw and alerted Apple to the issue. Forced entry could be triggered by sending a malicious message to a target. The group analyzed an iPhone back in March that belonged to a Saudi activist and found 27 GIF files, or GIF files, to each their own, but their digging helped them discover those files were actually Adobe Photoshop PSD and PDF files made up of 748 bytes of data. Now, these files caused an IM transcoder agent crash, which resembled the same kind of crash they saw previously from 9 different Bahraini activist phones. Now, each time, those fake GIF or GIF files were sent to the phone right before it was hacked. The agent is a component that is used to render images via iMessage, so it instead was used to deploy surveillance in this case. Apple described this vulnerability as one that can process a maliciously crafted PDF and lead to arbitrary code execution. They released a patch on macOS, watchOS, and iOS, saying that parsing a malicious PDF could give the attacker code execution capabilities. Citizen Lab believes that this vulnerability has been exploited remotely by NSO Group since at least February of 2021. While Pegasus is used to target activists, journalists, and people in places of power, even if you don't fall into one of those categories, you should still update your Apple device to ensure that you are protected. I love it when y'all send me these adorable pictures of your pets. So these are a few from my Hush Puppy Patreon Alliance members. And we have an interesting story, so I'm gonna go ahead and get into it with story number three. ExpressVPN has come under fire for a couple of enlightening news topics this past week. For starters, Cape Technologies announced that it is buying ExpressVPN for $936 million, which includes $237 million in Cape shares going to the ExpressVPN co-founders and the remainder to be paid in cash over 2 years. ExpressVPN currently has about 3 million customers, many of which are in America, and OEM partnerships with HP, Acer, Philips, Dynabook, and HMD Global. ExpressVPN states that they will continue to work as a separate service and will continue to grow. But this sale did create some criticism since Cape Technologies also bought ZenMate, CyberGhost, and PIA VPN, or Private Internet Access VPN. Cape Technologies was a rebranded company that originally came from a business called CrossRider, which reportedly worked with ad injection technology. Now, this was sketchy because it was flagged as malware by anti-malware software. Cape also bought Web Selenies, I think that's how you say it, back in March of this year, and that company runs two VPN review sites called VPN Mentor and WizCase. Huh, so that's interesting. So odd, right? Now they've bought ExpressVPN as well, which is one provider that you constantly see advertised by YouTubers, except for me. Next, a report surfaced about three former US intelligence operatives who worked as cyber spies for the UAE and their admission to violating US hacking laws and selling sensitive military technology. One of those former intelligence operatives now has a job at ExpressVPN. His name is Daniel Garrick, and he is the CIO. The three men worked on Project Raven by the United Arab Emirates to gather intel on journalists, activists, dissidents, and rivaling governments, and this project often targeted Americans. They also bought off former NSA and CIA operatives and got them to hack into US networks as well. ExpressVPN did issue a statement regarding the CIO, saying that they knew all about his history when he was hired, but also stating that they did not know of anything illegal or immoral, basically explaining that they knew he was a government contractor and that he worked for both US and UAE companies, but nothing about the classified work. If ExpressVPN is telling the truth, now that official court filings have been unsealed, they cannot deny what the three men have admitted to doing. In the court documents, it states the men violated the International Traffic in Arms regulations and conspired to commit access device fraud. It also included hacking offenses and explained that they had used a zero-click exploit and added it to a tool called Karma, which is what the UAE's Project Raven uses for hacks. Interestingly, prosecutors state that they are willing to drop the charges if the men cooperate with US authorities, they pay a financial penalty, and they agree to employment restrictions. Now that the studio is finished, I am back to filming content over here at youtube.com/Shannon Morse. Hit the subscribe button on that channel to see my upcoming review of the new Samsung foldables. I'm actually reviewing that this week and editing my content, and I'm so excited. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well, because we are on our way to 750,000 subscribers. Wow, that's crazy. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.